Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends. As we know that what is cell potential or what is standard cell potential, and based on that the Nernst equation has been now a new concept that we are going to learn. So what is Nernst equation and what is the relation that it shows? Let us see. So the Nernst equation gives an idea about what would be the cell potential or what would be the electrode potential of a particular anode or cathode with its concentration of the product or with the concentration of the reactant that has been involved in the overall galvanic cell. So let me give you an idea, or let me give you a short representation that what is Nernst equation. Nernst equation is represented by the formula E is equals to E naught minus 2.303 RT divided by NF log to the base 10 of concentration of product divided by the concentration of the reactant. In this case, E will be the potential of an electrode or potential of the cell, while the E naught will be standard potential of the electrode or can be the standard potential of the cell. If I will represent it E cell, then it will be the, that is, potential of the cell. Or then if I represent E naught as E naught cell, then it will be standard potential of the cell. And if I represent just by E, then it would be, or E of a particular electrode, like suppose Ag or manganese, or so this would be the electrode potential of that particular electrode. So this is how this has given an relation between the electrode potential and the standard electrode potential of a particular electrode or a particular cell. So let me give you much more idea, in which what you can see is what is R actually, and what is T and what is NF. So I have mentioned it here, where R is known as the gas constant, which has a value of 8.314 joules per Kelvin per mole, while as we know that the F is nothing but 96500 coulomb per mole, that is 1 Faraday, or you could say it as Faraday constant. So at 25 degree Celsius, what happens is, so 2.303 into R into T divided by F, if we'll calculate this thing, then we'll get a value of 0.0592 volt mole of electrons. So what will happen is, I could write this formula in this way, but just for 25 degree Celsius, okay, because it is a temperature dependent thing. So this cell potential will be E is equals to E naught minus 0.0592 divided by N, and in this case N means the number of electrons that is involved in the reaction or involved in the redox reaction. So into log of the concentration of product divided by the log of the concentration of the reactant. So how can we say that which one would be the product and which one would be the reactant? For that thing, what I have did is, I have represented a general formula or general electrochemical reaction, in which suppose A moles of A plus B moles of B, in which N moles of electrons are being involved, so as to give C moles of C plus D moles of D. So if in this case, suppose if I apply the Nernst equation, the thing that we could get is E cell is equals to E naught cell minus 2.303 RT divided by NF log of, in this case, the concentration of the product should be represented as a numerator, then in denominator we have to represent the concentration of the reactant. So the concentration of product, that is C raised to C, the stoichiometry, this is the stoichiometry of the product C, while concentration of D raised to D, this is similar like a chemical equilibrium that we have did in our 11th standard. So divide by the concentration of A raised to A and concentration of B raised to B. So since this is nothing but the chemical equilibrium constant that we have did in our 11th standard, so therefore I could write this thing as E cell is equals to E naught cell minus 2.303 RT divided by NF into log to the base 10 of K, that is equilibrium constant. So this is how we could represent, or we say about Nernst equation. So even though I can write the formula as this one, or for better convenience I could write the formula as this one. Very simple. And this formula will be very much influential in solving the numericals and to find out what would be the standard cell potential, or what would be the cell potential of a particular cell, by involving this kind of formula in it. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have got an idea that what is Nernst equation, and share this video with your friends. And yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.